Hello everyone, welcome back to Thrilling RP. We will cover how to scroll the frame or a multi-page without having the scroll bar displayed over the frame or the multi-page. So this is the typical method of scrolling a frame or a multi-page. So in order to avoid showing the scroll bar but still be able to scroll through the frame, we'll see how we can code this feature and utilize on the different pages of the frames. So this is our user form, this is a frame, and this is a multi-page. I'm having three pages here. These are typical labels colored in different backgrounds so that we can clearly identify that it is scrolling. Similarly, this is also a frame, but this frame has a property not to display the scroll bar. And similarly for the multi-page also, that scroll bar one, none of the scroll bar is visible, whereas the scroll height is maintained in both frame and the multi-page, in all the pages. There are different scroll height maintained. This page 3 has a scroll height of 600, this one is 700, and this one is 800. Page 1 is 800. So we are keeping the scroll height, but we are not displaying the scroll bars. So we are scrolling through the label. These are the labels, and we are clicking on the label so that the frame and or the page can crawl up and down. So let's go into the code and see what all we configured in this. So for the frame, this is label 1 and this is label 2. So we'll see what is label 1 and what is label 2 coded. So for label 1, on a mouse down event, so when we click down on the label, if button is 1, button 1 means if it is a left click, not the right click, button 1 is left click. So we defined a variable click underscore boolean as a boolean variable. Boolean means true or false variable. So if button is 1, then set click boolean equal to true and then run this procedure frame scroll up. So this label 1 is the up label, to scroll up. Similarly, label 2 is the scroll down label. So if it is label 2, everything is same, just run the procedure frame scroll underscore down. This is the procedure. We'll go into the all the procedure what we define. So this procedure requires an input variable click boolean. Whether a boolean variable is required to run this procedure and to find out the event whether the boolean is true or false. Again, for the label one, if mouse is up, if we release the left click, then set the click boolean variable value to false. So similarly for the label two, and for label 3 and 4, label 3 and 4, this is 3 and this is 4. For label 3 and 4, we are doing the same thing, just running the different procedure. This is multi-page scroll down and multi-page scroll up. Rest everything is same. So let's go into the module. Let's go for the frame scroll up. This requires a boolean variable. So set frame frm as the user form 1, uf1.frame1. So we defined as frm as the frame and cpg as the page of a multi-page. So this is a label, loop it. If the frame.scrollTop is not equal to 0, what it means is when we scroll it right up till the top, the frame scroll top is 0. If I scroll it down, you can see the scroll top value is changing. So this is what it is changing. The same applies to this also. The frame scroll top value is changing. Now scroll top value, when we fully scrolled it down, is 351, whereas the scroll height is 700. So scroll top is related somehow with the overall height of the procedure, but there is no direct relation. If you change the scroll height, or if you change the height of the control, I mean frame or the page, this relative ratio is not same. So what we are doing is if the scroll top is not equal to 0, then check if the click boolean is true, then scroll top equal to scroll top minus 0.1. This is what it is subtracting from the scroll top value when it is not 0 to make it 0. Do this, subtract the value from the scroll top, and then we're making it the application to wait for 100 milliseconds. This is millisecond. We defined a millisecond constant. So this is the number value of 1 millisecond. How we are getting it is 1 divided by 24 into 60 into 60 into 1000. When you do this calculation, you'll get this number. So this is the number value as for the Excel application for 1 millisecond. So I defined it as a constant. This is the number value. So we wait for let me comment it out. Okay, so we wait for 100 millisecond. The two events, whatever has been called, just display over it, just do the event, and then again wait for 100 millisecond, and then loop it, go to this label what we created here. So it'll as long as we keep the left click down, this application is this procedure will loop until it reaches zero. As soon as it reaches zero, the procedure will stop, and it will go to else of this first if statement, of this if statement, and the procedure will end. Otherwise, if it is not zero and we release the left click, then procedure will go to the else statement of the second if, and it will jump to stop it label and exit the procedure. So this is the basic idea on how we are showing the how we are implementing the effect of left click. To the time it is clicked down, it will keep on running, and as soon as we release the left click, the procedure will exit. So this is how it is happening. If I click on it and release it, it just scroll a little bit, and if I keep on keep the left click down, it will right away move up till the scroll height becomes zero. Similarly for this, for the down event, similar thing is happening. Only thing is, now we are adding it. If we scroll down, we are clicking it. Now we are just adding to the scroll top value. Now here the only difference is, we are the scroll top is a definite value that it cannot go beyond zero, but we are not certain about what will be the maximum scroll top value. So what we are doing is, we are defining two variable, last top as double and new top as double. So we set a frame, similar thing, last top equal to scroll top dot value, whatever is the initial value of the scroll top, we set it to last top, and then we set the new top value equal to plus 1, just adding a same something so that these two values are not same. So this is the initial values of last top and the new top. Now if the scroll top is equal to last top, then what we check is, if the scroll top is equal to last top, then loop for what? If last top is equal to new top, then go to stop it. If last top becomes new top, then go to stop it. Then second condition we check, if click boolean is true or not, then last top will become the scroll top value. The scroll top value then will add 0.1, and then we set the new top value to the scroll top value. So what we define here is just to start the loop. These are not the actual values. I mean, this is not the actual value. This is the same value. This is not the actual value. This is arbitrary value to start the loop. So once the loop starts, we define last top as the current scroll top. Then we add the 0.1 to the scroll top, and whatever value it becomes, then we assign it to the new top. So that last top and new top has a difference of 0.1. So similar thing, again wait for 100 milliseconds, do events, and wait for 100 milliseconds. So when if we keep on keep the left click down on the label, what it will do is, it will keep on running the value, and once it reaches the bottom of the last value of the scroll top, these two values will become equal. So the scroll top value will not change. Even if we force it to change it here, the scroll top value will not change when it hits the bottom of the scroll. So when these two value becomes equal, the procedure will jump to stop it and exit the procedure. Similarly, if in between we release the button, the click boolean will become false. If you remember here, click boolean will become false. If on the mouse up event, all mouse up event, click boolean becomes false. So this is the procedure for the down event, down scroll. Similarly, the same procedure is for the multi-page. The only difference is we are setting cPage as if current page as a user form 1 dot multi-page 1 dot pages and whatever is the active page. So this defines the active page index. So with the current page, same similar events are running. So this is how we are making it scroll without showing the scroll bar, and it is little, I feel it is little bit smooth than this. So this is the procedure we are adopting here. So there are couple of ways to do this. You can use the do while loop, you can use do until loop or do loop. There are many looping formulas, looping statements which can be used in this. I simply use label just for the simplicity of the explanation. So this is how we are making the label click scrolling of the frame or the multi pages.